Hello students, welcome to our class. Today we are going to discuss about some of the remaining MCQs in thermodynamics. What is the free energy change when a reaction proceeds with the enthalpy change of 250 kilojoules and the entropy of 40 joule per Kelvin at 27 degrees centigrade? This is the question. What is the free energy change? When the reaction proceeds with the enthalpy change of kilojoules per and entropy change of 40 joule per Kelvin. So this is the question. What is the free energy change? They are asking delta G. When a reaction proceeds with the enthalpy change of delta H is given minus 250 kilojoule per mole and entropy change of 40 joule Kelvin inverse mole inverse. Entropy is 40 joule Kelvin inverse mole inverse. Temperature also given 27 plus 273 300. Now we have to find out the delta G. Delta G is equal to delta H minus T delta X. So delta H is minus 250. So delta H is in kilojoules, make it in joules. Minus T 300 kelvins into delta H. So it become 1000. Okay. This one can be written like this. So So delta G is -262 kilojoules. Kilojoules per mole. Next, for the process CO2 solid gives rise to CO2 gas. CO2 solid gives rise to CO2 gas. So this is the process. Now they are asking what is the values of delta H and delta S. Delta H and delta S. To convert a solid into gas, you have to give the energy. Means by absorbing energy, solid is converting into gas. So absorbing energy means delta H is equal to positive. Next, what about entropy? In gas case, what happens when solid converting into gas? What happens to the entropy? Entropy increases. So entropy increase means positive. So delta H positive, delta S also positive. Next. H2O solid converting into H2O liquid at 0 degree centigrade and normal pressure. H2O solid is converted into H2O liquid at 0 degree centigrade. And the normal pressure, not atmospheric pressure. Then what is the relationship between delta H and ideal gas? This is the pressure. Delta H and P delta S. So converting a solid into liquid at this temperature and this pressure is a spontaneous process. So our formulas on these three things are related with delta G. Delta G is equal to delta H minus P delta S. This delta G is negative because conversion of a solid into liquid is exothermic. Spontaneous process. Melting of ice is a spontaneous process. So this becomes negative delta H minus P delta S. Bring the term to this side. So delta H is equal to P delta S. So this is the relationship for this equation. Delta H is equal to P delta S. Next, delta H is the enthalpy change and delta S is the entropy change. Accompanying a reaction. The reaction is spontaneous. Delta H is enthalpy change. We know that delta H is enthalpy change. Delta S is entropy change in the reaction. The reaction is spontaneous. So they are asking the reaction to become spontaneous. To become this reaction spontaneous, delta G must be negative. If you get the negative delta G value, if you want to get the negative delta G value, this delta H may be negative or this this must be positive, this whole value must be negative. Then we will get negative delta G, delta G value. That means delta H less than P delta. If this condition is satisfied, then we will get negative delta G. So delta G is positive and delta P delta H is higher, negative. In a reversible reaction, rate of forward and backward reactions become equal only when the free energy change accompanying it is. In a reversible reaction, rate of forward and backward reaction become equal only when the free energy change accompanying it. So they are asking rate of forward reaction is equal to rate of backward reaction. So this is the thing they are asking. This is possible when free energy change accompanying it is zero. That means rate of forward reaction is equal to rate of backward reaction, means that reaction is at equilibrium. So you have to find this condition satisfies the equilibrium conditions. Reaction is at equilibrium. Reaction is at equilibrium. When reaction is at equilibrium, then delta G free energy change is equal to, then delta G is equal to zero. These are the conditions. This is the problem condition. Rate of forward reaction is equal to rate of backward reaction is the condition in the problem. Now they are asking at equilibrium what is happening. So basing on this equilibrium, I am saying this reaction is at equilibrium. At equilibrium, delta G is equal to zero. Next, the tendency of a reaction take place spontaneously is high when the reaction is. Tendency of a reaction to take place spontaneously is high when the reaction is exothermic reaction. Then now, tendency of a reaction to take place spontaneously is high when the reaction is. So they are asking about the delta H and delta S. So the reaction is spontaneous. They are saying in the problem, the reaction is spontaneous. From the problem. Reaction is spontaneous. Now they are saying, when this spontaneous reaction is going to happen, when this one will happen, delta H is equal to negative, delta S is equal to, then only this reaction will become spontaneous. We know the spontaneity conditions. I will again show you delta G negative, delta H negative, delta S positive. These are the three conditions which shows the spontaneous of the reaction. delta G negative, delta H negative, delta S positive. These are the three conditions. It shows the spontaneity of the reaction. Next, for a reaction to be spontaneous at all temperatures, so they are asking for a reaction to be spontaneous at all temperatures, what is the condition? So the reaction is spontaneous. Conditions are required to get delta G negative. These are the conditions. If these conditions are there, then the reaction becomes spontaneous. Next. For a system in equilibrium, delta G is equal to 0. Delta G is equal to 0 means that the system is at the equilibrium. Then, what are the conditions of temperatures and pressures? Temperature and pressures are constant. At constant temperatures, if delta G is equal to 0, then the system is present at equilibrium. Next, for the process C plus O2 gives rise to CO2, it is found that delta G at a given temperature minus 40 kilojoules per mole. At this temperature, question mark. So they given an equation. C plus O2 gives rise to CO2. Delta G is minus 40 kilojoules per mole. Delta G is minus 40 kilojoules per mole. Now they are asking at this temperature what happens to the this reaction. This reaction becomes spontaneous because delta G is given as negative. Delta G is given as negative. Delta G negative means the reaction is spontaneous. Delta G negative means reaction is spontaneous. Reaction is spontaneous. In a flask, colorless N2O4 is in equilibrium with brown color N2O2. At equilibrium, when the flask is heated to 100 degrees centigrade, the brown color disappears. The brown color deepens, and on cooling, it becomes less color. The change in enthalpy for this system is They are asking the change in the enthalpy. So first N2O4 is there. This N2O4 converting into NO2. N2O4 is converting into NO2. N2O4 is colorless. This one is brown color. Now they are heating when the flask is heated to 100 degrees centigrade. The brown color deepens. Brown color deepens means the reaction is moving towards the environment side. When it is cooled, it becomes less intense. When it is cooling, the reaction is moving this side, N2O4, colorless side. From this observation, they are asking what is the enthalpy change. From this observation, they are asking what is enthalpy change. So this is the thing they are asking. On cooling, it becomes less color. The flask brown color at equilibrium and the flask is heated. So flask is heating. So when flask is heating, you are getting the brown color. Apply the mixture to your principle means at higher temperature you are getting brown color. At higher temperature, 100 degrees centigrade, you are getting brown color. Then apply the Schaffner principle. If the reaction is endothermic, to proceed endothermic reactions, you have to maintain higher temperatures. That is the Schaffner principle. To proceed endothermic reactions, you have to maintain the higher temperatures. So this must be an endothermic reaction. So this is positive delta H. This reaction is endothermic, the reaction is endothermic, then the reaction is moving towards the brown color. Delta H is positive. Next. The standard enthalpy change of the decomposition of N2O4 to NO2 is 58.04 kilojoules. The standard enthalpy change of the decomposition of N2O4 to NO2 is standard enthalpy change of converting N2O4 to NO2 is 58.04 kilojoules, and standard entropy of this reaction is enthalpy change is 58.04 kilojoules, and standard entropy of this reaction is 76.7 joule per kelvin. Standard free energy change for this reaction, temperature also is given 25 plus 27 degree. They are asking standard free energy change. Delta H minus P delta S. 5.39 kilojoules. Consider the following reaction in an automobile. The sign of delta S, delta S, delta G respectively. So the given reaction. The sign of delta H, delta S, delta G respectively. So they are asking the sign of delta H, delta S and delta G. So it is a spontaneous reaction, they are saying. It is a spontaneous reaction. So for spontaneous reaction, delta G is negative. This is a combustion reaction. For combustion reaction, combustion reactions are exothermic. So delta X is negative. Next, what about the delta? Yes. So here C5H8 is gas. Oxygen also gas. CO2 gas. H2O is given as liquid. So here how many moles are there? 27 moles are there. Here how many moles? 16 moles. Means, so what is happening here? Number of moles are decreasing. Number of moles are decreasing means entropy decreasing. Entropy decreasing means delta S negative. So this is the conditions. And another condition we can write, and that one is if this reaction becomes non-spontaneous, then delta G becomes positive. To get a positive sign for delta G, what about these things? It is an exothermic reaction, that one does not change. P delta X negative. Minus of minus positive. P delta X must be high. So These are the conditions. Next. In a chemical reaction, delta H is 150 kilojoules. Delta S is 100 joules per kilo. At 800 degrees, the value of delta H. Delta H is equal to 150 kilojoules. That equal to this many joules. Delta S is 100. Temperature 800. The value of delta G. Then use this is delta H minus T delta S number. Okay, subtract that. So it becomes 70 kilojoules. Here the answer is comes into joules. So in terms of kilojoules, 70 kilojoules. For a reversible reaction, half x plus 3 by 2y, use h to z. The delta H is minus 20 kilojoules. The values of standard entropies of x, y, z are entropies of s, entropies of x, 60, entropy of y, 40, entropy of z, 50. Temperature at which the above reaction attain equilibrium is about. So they are asking at what temperature this reaction is going to attain the equilibrium. So what we the temperature at which the above reaction attain equilibrium is about. So they are asking the equilibrium temperatures. For this, you first calculate the entropy change of this reaction. This is the reaction. Entropy changes half into 60 plus 3 by 2 into 40. This is 50. No, what happens? This is 30 plus Schrodinger's constant 50 minus entropy of reactants 90. Comes as minus 40. Now come to calculate the temperature. We know delta S is equal to delta H by T. Delta S is equal to delta H reversible by T. So delta H is 20,000. Temperature. Question mark. Delta S minus 1. Okay. These are in joules. So this is in joules. This one also in joules. So T is equal to. Now another two things are there. The enthalpy change for a given reaction at 298 Kelvin is minus Q joules per mole. If the reaction is spontaneous, then entropy change at that temperature is. Enthalpy change for a given reaction minus Q joules per mole. If the reaction